The exciting thing about working at UT Health is that we have so much amazing research, both clinical trials and research that's really still in the lab. But because we have such amazing scientists here, we're able to translate our work really from the bench to the bedside.
Our main focus is to come out with highly innovative ideas. We want to come out with the big breakthroughs, the things that will change the paradigms in science, with the long-term vision that we can contribute to eradicate these diseases.
Every other week, Dr. Soto and I meet. We have lots of ideas to exchange, and sometimes he gives me an idea of what he's doing in the lab that we could translate clinically, and other times I say to him, hey, you know, I've made this observation clinically. Maybe you guys could actually figure out why that is in the lab, and then we could use that information. What really attracted me to UT was the number of people like Dr. Soto who are doing some really stellar basic science work.
I think what characterizes UT Health is that we have vast collaborations between neurologists. As an MS specialist, I will talk to people who are Alzheimer's specialists, Parkinson's specialists, people who know other type of neurodegenerative disease, and we'll try to understand not just our own particular specialty, but try to understand what is common across these neurological diseases.
I think we're unique in that we really are able to offer a multidisciplinary approach in treating our patients.
In 2010, I had a stroke, and I just got up in the morning, I just couldn't shower. I got an MRI and a PET scan.
The neuroimaging is a set of different techniques, such as MRI or nuclear medicine type of technique, that allow us to look into the brain in a non-invasive way. I think it's gonna help us understand not just one disease, but an individual patient's disease.
Interventional neurology is a field where we create images of the blood vessels and the brain and the spinal cord, and we can fix the problems that we see. So these are problems that 10, 20 years ago, you'd come in, you'd have a big brain surgery where they drill off the skull, dig through the brain, and you have a long recovery in the hospital and the ICU afterwards. But nowadays, you come into the hospital, no cutting, no suturing, we just go up through the artery of the leg with one small needle stick, and we fix the problem right there. Oftentimes, go home the same day.
UT Health is one of the few places in Texas that offers single fiber EMG, and it's important technology because we've been able to give patients diagnoses that have gone for a long time without an answer. And we've also been able to treat these patients, and they've done better for it and changed their life in some cases. What I love about my job is taking care of patients, being able to give them an answer and walk them through treatment and prognosis, and really seeing patients get better.
The caregiver is the one person who, within the neurologic world, that tends to be left out the most. The caregiver sometimes is the voice of patients who cannot speak for themselves.
We saw another group of physicians prior to coming to UT Health, and I can honestly say the difference here is amazing.
At UT Health, we try to provide that level of understanding and education for caregivers and kind of prepare them for what's going to be lying ahead.
That makes me happy because now I feel more empowered to help Dan.
Neurology was a field that up until 10 or 20 years ago, we didn't have much to offer. We are making such differences in the care of patients by what we're doing in the lab. Over the next few years, as we build more collaborative efforts with other departments and even within ourselves, we'll have more and more discoveries that we'll be able to rapidly translate into patients who need therapies.